Congratulations on the victory over Surrey. After the defeat there early in the season, it must be very satisfying to record a more convincing win.
Yeah, absolutely. We were disappointed the last time we played them down there. We got a really slow start, dug ourselves a bit of a hole, and you know, they really ran at us very well, and our defensive transition was poor. So we did a lot of work in the week on trying to slow them down, getting them into a half-court game, but and for us to just really control the tempo of the game, and I thought we did that really, really well. Played very well together collectively, both offensively and defensively, and came away with a really good win.
It was Surrey's lowest tally, I believe, of the season, so that defensive mentality, was that something that you exaggerated in the game plan?
Yeah, most definitely. We played zone, played a lot of zone, and again, just two reasons really. A, to slow them down, but B, to sort of keep our big men out of foul trouble. So we thought we'd play a bit of zone and just give them something else to look at and think about. And you know, as the half went on, you know, Surrey really didn't figure it out. So we just stayed with that mentality for the rest of the game. And say defensively, we were solid. We limited them to one shot per possession, which was good. And down to the other end, we got the ball to the right people at the right time where they could be effective with it. And you know, I thought it was a really good game of basketball from us.
One of those effective players, as you said, LVC Dusha, recorded 14 points, 3 steals and 6 assists. So obviously implying how big a miss he has been for you in recent weeks, and how glad are you to have him back in the team?
Yeah, really pleased to have him back, because he's a different type of point guard than we've got with Ashton Khan and George Beeman. And excuse me, so he brings us a little bit more stability, a bit more structure within the play. And you know, he came on and actually just followed on from what he did against Manchester, really, just running the sets properly. Getting the ball to the right people at the right time. He brings a lot of energy. He's very, you know, very talkative, and we kind of kicked on from there. So really delighted with what he did, and you know, more of the same from him. Really, it would be really nice to have.
And of course, that's two wins on the bounce, both away from home. So you'll be itching, obviously, to record a win here on Friday against Plymouth.
Yeah, we're desperate to get a win here. I think we've played some good basketball here, but unfortunately, haven't been able to get over the line and win those games. So. As I say, with Dusha back, it gives a bit more of a rotation that we can look at. Plymouth are just coming off the back of a fantastic win against Newcastle, so they're going to come in here with a lot of confidence. You know, and we should have beaten Newcastle away, so I think it's going to be a cracking game on Friday against two teams who are, you know, fighting to sort of climb the way up the table.
Of course, you mentioned the 89-73 win they had over Newcastle over the weekend. A win against them that will see you go level on points in the table with a game in hand. So is there any added incentive as you look to progress up the table, or are you just going to treat it as any normal game?
Just a normal game. I mean, the fact is we want to win at home, and it seems to be a long time since we've done that. So that's the sort of the pressure we're putting on ourselves. We need to get a win at home. We've had some actually fantastic crowds here and getting behind the team, so we need to reward them. So treating it as another game. We're going to do our preparations as well as we do with any other team, and then hopefully we, you know, coaches, we can come up with a game plan that's going to get us over the line.
Paul, best of luck on Friday.
It's brilliant. Thank you very much.